What if I tell you that your brain is like a light bulb? What if I tell you that this organ that we all have in our heads needs electricity in order to function properly? And that it's because of this electricity that we can move, speak, feel, and see. It allows us to learn things like playing an instrument, drive a car, or solve a mathematical problem, and remember moments like the one we're living right now. Luckily for us, our brains are not exactly like a light bulb. That would be a little bit weird if our heads start shining light everywhere across the room. However, if their electric circuits stop working, even if it's just for a few seconds, the consequences can be devastating. This is what happens after suffering a stroke, a disease that I'm sure that most of you are familiar, either because it touched you, a loved one, or someone you know. One in four adults will have a stroke at one point in their lives. And right now, there's around 100 million of people living with the long-term consequences of this condition, making a stroke one of the leading causes of disability worldwide. Movement, memory, or speech problems are some of the most common symptoms. Symptoms that can last up to several months and even up to years, affecting the quality of life of those who suffer it, but also the ones around them. But what if I could tell you that there are things that we can do to improve and accelerate stroke recovery? What if we could bring back the light in the brain? Hello, everyone. My name is Bernat de las Heras, and I'm a PhD student at McGill University, studying how the brain changes and recovers after stroke. One of the things that fascinates me the most about the human brain is that despite severe damage, it has a remarkable capacity to recover. Like a good electrician, our brains can repair themselves by reestablishing the electrical connections that have been damaged by the stroke. And this is possible thanks to a process known as brain plasticity, which is the ability of our brains to change and adapt in response to experiences. When we learn a new skill, like a new dance move or a new language, our brains and their neural circuits change. And are these exact same processes that can help them recover after injury. And what is even more interesting is that the same way that you need intense training and regular practice to get pretty good at these skills, there are certain treatments and interventions that can improve this brain plasticity and opening new opportunities for recovery. Today, I will reveal to you a revolutionary treatment that we're investigating right now in our laboratory. Imagine a treatment with capacity to improve stroke recovery and offset most of the symptoms all at once, with capacity to reduce fatigue and increase levels of energy and fitness, which are reduced almost by half in most of the patients, that can improve mobility deficits in activities that are essential for our daily living, such as walking, that improves memory, sleep quality, and symptoms of anxiety and depression, which are very common after stroke. Imagine that this treatment could even protect our brains by reducing the risk of suffering future strokes. And finally, that is completely free and available for everyone. Well, the reality is that you don't need to imagine it, as this treatment is not any magical pill or any miraculous solution. This treatment has already been invented and is called exercise. Yes, you heard it well. Physical exercise, moving our bodies, increasing our heart rate, has shown to be one of the best medicines for stroke recovery. This simple intervention has shown to be an effective way to protect, maintain, and restore the health in our brains. And guess what? One of the main causes of this is its ability to promote brain plasticity. When we move, when we do physical exercise, our brains are flooded by many chemicals. Chemicals that can make our brains more plastic and amenable to changes, making them more ready to learn, to remember, and yes, you guessed it, also to recover. In our lab, we study what are the effects of exercise on brain plasticity and recovery in stroke patients. We design individualized exercise programs with the goal of improving the fitness levels of these patients. But at the same time, we use neuroimaging techniques to measure and test what is the electrical circuits in their brains. If we look into a healthy brain, what we typically see is a very good balance of brain activity between both hemispheres. After stroke, however, this perfect balance can be disrupted, and the affected side of the brain sometimes can show reduced and even inexistent capacity to send electrical signals to the rest of the body, which is a common sign in those patients that have mobility problems. In our lab, one of the studies saw that just one bout of exercise, just one session of exercise, can trigger changes in the brain that can help rebalance the activity between both hemispheres. And we're seeing similar findings after 8 weeks of exercise, where in addition of improving their fitness levels by almost 25%, patients show more balanced patterns of activity by the end of the program. So yes, it seems that exercise is indeed a revolutionary treatment for stroke recovery. The reality, however, is that despite all these benefits that I just told you, most patients continue to be sedentary and inactive after stroke. But why? What are the reasons? Well, fear, lack of knowledge about the benefits of exercise, or not having access to resources or rehabilitation specialists are some of the main barriers. Also, unfortunately, exercise programs are not always offered to patients, to all the patients in rehabilitation hospitals and clinics, preventing many to benefit from this type of training. But if we look at the evidence, it's sound and clear. Once the patient is medically stable, exercise should be a fundamental part of the recovery program. If we look at the current guidelines, to obtain the most benefits, exercise sessions should last between 20 and 40 minutes, with a frequency of 3 to 5 times a week, and ideally reaching moderate exercise intensities, which is when we exercise and we start breathing harder than normal. It's fascinating, because these programs also have to be, it's very important that they are completely personalized and adapted to the patient's preferences. And perhaps what is even more important, if you want these patients to continue exercising as a lifelong activity, we have to make sure that these programs are also enjoyable. So, walking, biking, hiking or dancing, alone or in a group, there's infinite options we can choose, but it's important that patients choose one activity that they have fun with. Before, when I started this talk, I mentioned that we can bring back the light in the brain. And probably some of you are wondering why I'm comparing this to exercise right now. Well, 4 years ago, when I started my studies, I was very curious about how our patients were feeling with the exercise that we were doing. I asked one of the first patients that completed one of our exercise programs how she thought that exercise affected her recovery. Like many others, she had difficulties in moving her arm, she had extreme fatigue, and also was struggling with symptoms of anxiety and depression. Believe it or not, I still remember her answer, as it is the one that inspired me to be here in front of you today. She told me, "Exercise brought back the light in my brain." And I hope that this talk can also bring light to yours. Thank you very much.